Hi, this is Asing. You are now watching Asing Math TV. In this video, we will learn how to obtain the probability of a binomial distribution by using Casio calculator. First, input the function of a binomial distribution by assuming that n and p are fixed since most of the time they are given. So we have n, which is 8, input 8, and we have c, combination, shift, divide. X unknown, so we have alphabet X times P given by the question is 0.2 to the power of alphabet X, and we times Q. Q is 1 minus P. Of course, we can input 0.8 directly, or we want to be safe, we can put 1 minus 0.2. with bracket. Bracket is very important, to the power of entire term here, n minus 1. So which means that we must put bracket. What is n? 8 minus x, and close bracket. Then press the calculate button. Calculate what is the value of x when x is equal to 3, and we press equal, then we will obtain the correct value. Now, lastly, the question asks for an interval, so we just have to calculate one by one. So first, calculate the value when x is equal to 1. So we calculate again when x is equal to 1 and press equal. Before we proceed to the second value, x equal to 2, remember to store the value first, because at the end, we should sum up all the values that we obtain. So to store, press shift, recall to get a store, and we press the button containing A. So check, press left, is being stored. Then we delete A and we proceed to the second, calculate when x is equal to 2. And press equal, store again. Now this time we should store in B. Check again, store. So we delete. Now we should proceed to calculate when x is equal to 3. So we have 3 equal. Store again. Store in C. For this time, remember to store in different alphabets. Check again. C. Delete. Now we proceed to calculate the value when it is 4. Press equal. Now shift recall to get store in D. So check again, everything being stored. Press AC. Now we should sum up the value. Remember where we store? A for when x is equal to 1. Plus when x equal to 2, B. Plus when x equal to 3, C. Plus when x equal to D, 4. So we have equal, then we will obtain the value. As we can see, this method is faster as compared to we calculate manually. Okay, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this. See you.